withhold. You know, the concluding part of Proverbs chapter 11 verse 21:5 says, and there is one who withholds more than is right, but it leads to poverty. There is one who withholds more than is right, but it leads to poverty. There is time for everything. You know, there is time to laugh and time to cry, the time to embrace and the time to refrain from embracing, time to encourage and time to rebuke. Like, there's time for everything, you know, the time to give and the time to withhold from giving. God has made everything beautiful in His own time. So as good as giving is, there is also time to withhold from giving. Today's wisdom of Solomon says, there is one who withholds more than is right, but it leads to poverty. So a little bit of withholding is right, but must not be beyond what that is right. And why is it that a little bit of withholding is required? Proverbs 21 verse 20 says, there is desirable treasure in oil in the dwelling of the wise, but a foolish man squanders it. The King James Version says, a foolish man spended it all. So a little bit of withholding is required, because to be wise, you need to have desirable treasure and oil in your dwelling. So there is much treasure and oil in the dwelling of the wise, but only a fool will spend it all. See, if I spend it all, I am a fool. If you spend it all, you are also a fool. Not Bimi Tokam, not Solomon. No, he is a fool because he is not futuristic in his thinking. No, at the time of plenty, you must prepare for the time of famine. There is plenty in your life today, so you can adequately prepare for the time of famine. Now, the season of famine will surely come to individuals. It will come to every family. It will come to organizations. And those that will enjoy plenty throughout are the wise. Those who gather enough food at the time of plenty for the time of famine. Now, the question is, which season are you? Are you in the season of plenty or famine? But wise, wisdom demands you know when to withhold from giving and engage in serious business that will increase your capacity to give more in the future. Imagine what will happen if Bishop David Oyedepo gave out all the money used to build Covenant and Landmark University. Imagine what will happen if Joseph gave out all the 20% of the food he's supposed to store against the time of famine. Just imagine what will happen. Just imagine what the situation will look like when the famine eventually struck. Almost all the nation will be wiped out because that simple wisdom of keeping 20% of the food that we harvested during the plenty period is meant to save the world. Now, giving it out during the time of plenty, what will happen? The nation will be wiped out. So you must learn to withhold. So just be sure that your withholding is not as a result of greediness and lack of mercy. You know, some people, they don't give because they are just greedy and they don't have mercy. They've forgotten that Jesus Christ said, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. So be sensitive to the Holy Spirit. Be flexible. Also learn to withhold your money from those that comes to request for money to do the same thing every year, they come this year for house rent, next year they come again for house rent, the third year they come again for house rent. Those people, see, start withholding from them because they are not ready to learn wisdom. What is supposed to be doing when you come to me this year for house rent and I give it to you, and you come another time for another house rent, I will send you away because I will say you are not serious. Because what I expect you to do is you coming to me and say, see, I'm tired of coming to beg for house rent from you. Please show me the way so that I can be able to pay my house rent myself. So to such people that comes to you every day, year in, year out, for the same thing, give me money to do this same thing, send them away. Withhold your money from them because they are not ready to learn wisdom. So there is much oil and treasure to be desired in the house of the wise. Are you wise? I urge you to do everything in your power to be wise.